Hello, this is Fred, the agronomist and a farmer, and we are back to class. Welcome back again. Thank you for being my follower. Thank you for following my training. Invite a friend, invite a farmer, so that we can be a big class. If you have not subscribed to this channel, kindly subscribe, so that you can continue getting the updates and the training in matters farming. The question is, can a tomato do well under farrow irrigation? Yes. Big percentage of tomatoes that we have been consuming in Kenya or in East Africa is directly or it's growing under farrow irrigation. And for you to grow successfully or for you to have a successful tomato farming under farrow irrigation, there are some few aspects you have to consider. Remember our previous class about farrow irrigation, what you have to check for you to have successful farrow irrigation, the gradient and the availability of water. We are not going to touch on the two, but today we'll touch on the soil. For successful farrow irrigation or for you to grow successfully tomatoes in under farrow irrigation, one, your soil must have good water holding capacity, and in most cases is the loam soil. It's very good when it comes to holding water, and this among the factors you have to consider. If it is poor in holding water, it can release water very easily or at a very high speed, especially the sandy soil. Don't try this type of farrow irrigation, because remember, the water flow is not piped. The basin are not at any given point controlled, or we don't control any water, though it's just flooding the basin by use of the tunnels that are in between the farm. And we have to take, sometimes you cannot be doing this daily, so it has to be, you have to take sometimes, remember you're using a lot of fuel, and the job is tiresome, also it needs a lot of labor for you to make sure you irrigate the farm. So these are the things you have to put into consideration when you're coming to tomato farming. So how do you plant the tomatoes? Here are the steps. One, you make the basins. You make sure the basins are readily made. Then, after making the basins, now that those are, after making sure you have a good basin and the water tunnel is good, you come, you make the planting holes. The planting holes are made for you to be able to plant using manure and all, using fertilizers. After making the planting holes, now, that way now we apply the fertilizer, then all the manure. Then from there, remember we've marked the holes. Even if you irrigate the you plant the area, the demarcation of the holes will still be visible. So you are going to plant tomatoes direct to those holes. And the other reason why you make the holes, it's very easier to plant them, because remember we made the holes, and the place is soft when it's irrigated, so it's easier to place your tomato there and plant them. So from there, you come with your tomatoes and plant them. It's as easier as that. Then what follows is the routine irrigation, controlling of the pesticide diseases, and also the supporting of the crop. Please note, this method under any crop uses a lot of water, and it can easily cause the fungal diseases, so you have to be very keen. There are some areas where farrow irrigation is not encouraged, especially in areas where we receive heavy rainfall in cold and wet areas. We don't encourage farrow irrigation. So in most cases, the dry areas are with plenty of water, because I understand that some of the dry areas, there are big rivers that pass through there. Those are the suitable places where you can grow your tomato or any other crop under farrow irrigation. So those are the simple steps on how to grow your tomatoes, on how tomatoes are supposed to be grown under farrow irrigation. For more management of tomatoes, I've done good trainings about tomato management. You can go check how to manage your tomatoes, and also I'll continue doing more and more to make sure you're updated, you're getting the skills, and you're learning from the best, and that is from practical, not from me, from the practical point of view. I will be learning from other farmers and also from me, but specifically practical things. Make sure you subscribe to this channel so that you can continue learning together. Bye.